Sunrise, Cac, Lemon Zest, and White Puri were all tied for number one this year. This is a late season mango. I'm going to call it a late season mango because it's later in the season and it's still loaded. This is my sweet tart mango. It seemed like the whole season I had Dunkin' mangoes on this tree, and there's still a bunch. I mean, every day I come out here. This is a Honey Kiss, traditionally a late season mango, and there's still mangoes on there. This is a step mango, and there's still a lot of mangoes on this step mango. This tree is loaded. This is Little Gem. An Orange Essence is a late season mango that's has a good amount on there. Hello everybody, welcome to Fruitful Trees, and it's that time again. Like I've been doing every first of the month this summer, I've been filming my trees to show everybody the different mangoes and where they're at and what's going on with the mangoes in the season and what mangoes are early, mid, and late. Last video we did was the mid-season mangoes, and now we got late-season mangoes hanging on our trees, and we're going to look around my yard and get an update, and either in another video or maybe even at the end of this video, we'll look at my neighbor's yard as well and see what's happening with his late season varieties, because they are similar varieties. So use this video as a reference if you're going to grow mangoes, which varieties are later and when they're in bloom and so on. Now, the early mangoes were late this year, but the later mangoes are on time in terms of not being extra late. So the season wasn't necessarily pushed back. It was just squeezed together where the early ones were a little later, but the late ones are still on time. So it was a shorter season, or is a shorter season. But we still have a good amount of mangoes on the trees. So let's see what we have, okay? Here's my lemon zest tree. And it was a good year for lemon zest. I thought my neighbor was going to have a lot of problems with bacterial black spot, but it turned out he had a good amount of mangoes. So that's lemon zest. Still the best. Lemon zest is the best. There's some close seconds. But lemon zest was phenomenal this year. Love it. Here's a tree that's loaded right now. This is a late season mango. I'm going to call it a late season mango because it's later in the season and it's still loaded. This is my sweet tart mango, and also known as the branch breaker. My tree did not break a branch. It's coming close to doing so, but my neighbor's tree did break a branch. And as you can see, this branch is, it's bending. It's bending. As a matter of fact, these might be holding up each other, but there's a bunch of sweet tart still on there. And this is a mango I hadn't known when to pick the last couple years, but now that I got this nice crop, I'm kind of learned when to pick them. It's a really nice mango. I like it. I like it. This is a tree that at the beginning of the season, I wasn't sure what it was, but I thought it was a mislabeled because it was supposed to be a sugarloaf. But after pulling some mangoes off of it, Alex at Tropical Acres Farms confirmed that that is a sugarloaf. That is a sugarloaf. Sugarloaf mango. And those ended earlier. Those were mid-season, and there's no more on there now. This is a cac tree. Cac. There's still one cac hanging on. And this is a very close second as my favorite mango this year. Lemon zest was still the best, but cac was right up there. Very impressed with cac. The tree's starting to take off. It's supposed to be a very vigorous tree, and it looks like it's starting to take off. So that's a cac tree. And by the way, now's the time, once you pull off those mangoes, or you get that last mango, is to trim your trees if you're going to trim them. Now's the time. So, as we look here, my China jackfruit's already done for the season. And a branch actually broke from the wind. So, but we got what we needed. And coming along here, we're going to look at mangoes. For the sake of this video, we'll look at everything else another time. I just want to go over mangoes, what's happening, what's not happening. This is orange sherbet. Orange sherbet is still loaded. Loaded. So I still have a lot of orange sherbet. It's a tricky mango about when to pick them. It's been at least, because a lot of them, if you pick them ripe on a tree, they end up being like a jelly seed. At least my tree. But orange sherbet, I have. My neighbor still has sweet tart and orange sherbet in his yard. That's orange sherbet. We turn around here. See all my papaya trees are growing in. This is growing great. This is my red custard San Pablo. But here we got my lemon meringue trees. My lemon meringue trees are done for the season because they're normally early season. I had a few, but I did make another video where I trimmed them and I opened up the center. Beautiful. That's my lemon meringue. Now we come here. This tree is loaded. This is a delicious late season variety. It's called M4. It has a coconut flavor. These are ready to be picked, as a matter of fact. You see that I'll pick this. There'll be nothing coming out, no juice coming out. This is an M4 mango, a good crop this year. And I'm going to have to move this tree. It's definitely getting crowded in here. I'm already getting budwood to top work another tree so I can move this one. But that's M4. So for late season, we're doing pretty good this year. This one is Duncan / Sunrise. So Sunrise, we're done with Sunrise on it because we top worked the Duncan to a Sunrise, but a lot of Duncan stayed on there. But look, Duncan is still all over this tree. Now Duncan is interesting. It's like an early season, mid-season, and late season. It seemed like the whole season I had Duncan mangoes on this tree, and there's still a bunch. I mean, every day I come out here, and as a matter of fact, I was going to top work this completely to a Sunrise. I don't even prefer the Duncan, but I'm going to keep it because it's so prolific and it's a great mango to share with others. And also, the later season ones are a lot better than the early season ones. But that's Duncan. And that's all the mangoes back here. We'll look at our other trees another time. We're going to go to the... Oh, and then we got this one. This was my top work. This is my emerald tree. The top work's looking real nice. I top worked a cherry tree to emerald. And it's looking nice. And that one is a seedling. We'll go to the front, and then we'll go to Mango Land and see what's happening. All right. So this is my cocktail tree where I have Fairchild, Angie, and Kent on here. It was originally a Kent tree that I top worked. Angie's done. Finished. Fairchild's finished. And the Kent is coming out here. This one branch is a Kent branch. Kent's a later season one, and I have three Kents on it. So I initially top worked this tree because the Kent mango gets the bacterial black spot, and I didn't want the tree, but I kept one branch. But the tree's looking nice, and it's growing well. I have a persimmon here that looks like it's not doing too well, so I might take that out because it's in the way of this anyway. And then coming on over here, I have it was a Cog's Hall or Cog's Shore, but as you can see, I top worked it to an ice cream. This branch definitely took. You see how skinny the leaves are. This branch, these other branches didn't take. And as much as I don't like the cocksure, other people are saying they like it, so I might keep it for them. And I got my ice cream branch on this, or I might just top work it. And this is a Pickering. Pickering did wonderful this year. Dwarf tree did excellent. So I'm very satisfied with that. Even though it's not my favorite mango, I actually don't even like Pickering. But everyone seems to love it. So I can't eat all these mangoes. So instead of getting another tree, I'm sharing a lot of these with my neighbors. Starfruit's about to come in. Starfruit tree's loaded. It's been a good year. Okay, coming on over here. I have a new tree that I planted. This is an Amarpali tree. I had an Aki here, an Aki tree that I got rid of because it grows way too tall And this is Amrapali. I put that in because it's a dwarf tree. And I don't want this tree to grow too big, but it's in my neighbor's yard. He's letting me put a tree here. And I don't want it to get too big, so I put the Amrapali here. And then over here is the Jahingar that I planted a while ago. Nothing on there yet. And the summertime is a good time to plant new trees with all the rain. It really does help. And then in my neighbor's yard here, who's been so generous that I could plant stuff, I had planted an apricot mango tree. So that's apricot mango. And the first tree I planted here was my sunrise. This, I take it back what I said about lemon zest. Sunrise, cack, lemon zest, and white puri were all tied for number one this year. Sunrise was amazing. And the tree's growing beautifully. And I recently planted a P22 mango here, P22. And this was just a wild seedling that was here for a long time. And I top worked it this year several years ago, I top worked it into a pineapple pleasure. And it got a good amount of mangoes this year, but I didn't get to eat any of them. So my other neighbor came and took them. But at least it worked. It got some mangoes. And then the other tree I'll show you here is this tree. This is a dwarf Hawaiian, which I thought it was dead, but I moved it several times. I got it in the ground here, and it looks like it's coming back. So that's a dwarf Hawaiian tree. And you see my trees in the background. I already cut that white sapote, trimmed it. There's my yard over there. So that's what's growing on here. And then we have a star apple I put in a while ago, looking nice. Now let's go over to Mango Land and see what's happening there. Okay, everybody, here we are at Mango Land. And we had this dwarf jackfruit. We pulled a couple of jackfruits off of. It was nice. But let's check out the trees. We have a Brahm Kai Mei right here. I got one mango off it recently. It's not ripe yet. But now here we are, August 1st. And I got one off there. And then this one's a Pim Sam Moon. I thought I saw one on there, but can't find it. I'm coming through here. This is an ice cream, a top work. It was a seedling of a Julie that the former tenant had here. I top worked it to an ice cream. And I got a good amount of mangoes off this year, but they were early to mid-season. Actually, mid-season, they're all gone now. Now, this was my first mango this summer. This was the Rosy Gold. They're all gone now. That's Rosy Gold. This is a Honey Kiss, traditionally a late-season mango. And there's still mangoes on there. Honey Kiss. There's several still on there. Excellent mango, great late season variety, Honey Kiss. Over here we have a Juliet. It's growing nicely, but there wasn't any mangoes on there this year. And then back there we have this one is a Tess Pollock. Now Tess Pollock was a disappointment in the taste this year, but it was the first time I got mangoes on there, so we'll wait and see. But it was more of an early season or early mid-season mango. There's nothing on there now. And this is the tree that I'm thinking about top working, at least half of it, over to an M4. I actually started the process. We'll see how it goes. Space. It's tough around here, but that's what we got now. That's that tree. I got a bunch of other trees here, but as for mango trees, they're mostly in the back. Now, on this side here, we had a star apple. And I changed it, so I wanted to find a spot and get this in the ground. And this is a creme brulee mango. So I put that creme brulee mango in there because this banana is going to be temporary. And that has a lot of good amount of room. So I got creme brulee there. And I moved the star apple to the front of the house, and hopefully it'll be successful. But I moved the camito over there. And then I have one other tree here. That's a mango. And normally this is a late season mango, but this was a mango I had moved several years ago. And even though it's still alive, it hasn't gotten any mangoes this year. This is a Neelim mango tree. And it's going to be a temporary tree because when that Pace Mamey grows, one of these is gonna have to go. And I'd much rather have that than this. But for now, it's here. And I even have a graft on here of a lemon zest. Yeah, this is lemon zest, this little grafted part. Okay, now we're gonna go to the back of Mangoland, August 1st, 2024. And we're gonna see what's still in season for the late season mangoes. Here we are. Peach cobbler. Did it great. I only had about 5 mangoes on it this year, but it was excellent. This is a big tree. I got a great spot for it. I'm excited about peach cobbler. This tree is loaded. This is little gem. This is a little gem tree and it's loaded. However, I personally am not a lover of the flavor or the taste of little gem. So there's a very good chance I'm going to top work this tree, because I need a spot for my apricot mango, and that might be the spot. But regardless, Little Gem is a late season mango, and it's one of the reasons I got it. Alex says it's often his latest season mango of all the mangoes. It's Little Gem, and there's a ton of mango still on the tree. I'm coming out over here. I have my Sunrise mango. Now the Sunrise is interesting because it's kind of tilting. It's just the way the graft came out. But there's a tilt on it. And Sunrise was over weeks ago, but I found 2 days in a row a mango on the floor. And I checked this tree and I didn't see anything, but 2 Sunrises were on the floor 2 days in a row, but now it's gone. It's not traditionally a later season mango. But what is a later season mango is this one. This is Orange Essence. And Orange Essence is a late season mango that has a good amount on there still. Orange Essence. Okay, next we have this step mango. This one's from Hawaii. I spoke about this several times this year. This is a step mango, and there's still a lot of mangoes on this step mango. So it didn't have the best flavor this year, but Alex promises me this is a good tasting mango. His first year mangoes don't always taste great. It does great, but we're waiting to see how that'll do. Now, of course, there I have my Sunrise, which we just spoke about. That is a mango I put in this summer between the trees. Now, originally I had a pina colada tree there, but I took it out because I was concerned about the spacing. I still am concerned about the spacing. But as a temporary tree, I put another one in there to try to get some mangoes, and it's growing nicely. That was a 3-gallon tree when I put it in the ground, and it's looking real nice. That is a Karen Michelle. 10 feet apart, way too close. That's why I took the pina colada out. However, I'm going to get mangoes off that for a couple of years before it really needs to come out and either be moved, or I could use the budwood and top work it. In the meantime, I'll get mangoes off that. As opposed to it just sitting in a pot getting much less mangoes. So that's Karen Michelle. This tree here did great. This is a dot mango. And it's done. Mid-season, had a lot of mangoes on there, but not a late season. This one is a triple sec mango. That's done as well. Coconut cream. Bad year for coconut cream for most people. For this, it's a newer tree. I didn't have any fruit on it, but it's doing really nice. I got my sugarloaf here. I had about 3 mangoes on this one this year. Very nice. Now there's my white puri, which was a superstar this summer. Superstar. Now there's nothing on there now, but definitely recommend white puri. Again, I had a Kathy here before between the dot and the white puri, and I took it out because I was concerned with the space. Well, I temporarily put a new tree in there, and that is a fruit punch. It's a temporary tree. Same goal as I said with the Karen Michelle. Coming back here is a Phoenix. I didn't have anything on the Phoenix this year. I had one growing on it that I took it off to let the tree grow. That is a Graham mango. It held some a little bit late, but nothing on there now. That's Graham mango. And coming over here, see, I had originally here, I had a Giselle mango between the white puri and the Super Alfonso that I had taken out and since had put a banana in. So the Super Alfonso is excellent mango, but there's nothing on there. It's done. And it went pretty late. Some people still have some on theirs. But it was about a week ago where I pulled the last couple off this tree. Oh, wait, there's still one on there. Look at that. August 1st, there's still a Super Alfonso on that tree. Very nice. Let's see if I can get that. That's pretty high up there. I'm gonna come back for that. All right. Here we got another situation. That is a buttercream. And that is a guava. This has always long been my plan. This is gonna be a temporary tree, this buttercream. Leaving, right now they're 10 feet apart. When it grows big enough, I'm gonna take that out, leaving the Super Alfonso with 20 feet over to the guava. Okay, here's a sweet tart mango. This was my first top work tree that I did from a pot. It's growing nice. It had several mangoes on it this year, but nothing now. And guava as well was more of an early mid-season. Nothing on there now. Now we have our pickering. I got this pickering from Leaf years ago. It did great this year in terms of regrowing, but we had about 5 or 6 mangoes on here. The tree's growing well. Here's the situation though. I put in the ground here apricot mango with enough space from the other trees, thinking I'd get rid of the pickering and keep the apricot. However, that pickering looks so nice and I don't want to move it again, and it's a dwarf tree. It's fitting there nicely. So I'm going to top work the little gem tree with this apricot tree in the future. That's my plan. Definitely too tight to leave there next to the pickering, which I could still do as an experiment and see when you plant those trees that's 10 feet apart how it'll grow, because it might get one side. It might work. So maybe I'll leave it as an experiment, but I don't think so. And originally, I even had a Glen tree here in the middle. Wayne, this is a great example. 10 feet, 10 feet, 10 feet. Graham, that's a fruit cocktail, which I had mid-season. Nothing on there now. But if there was a Glen in the middle there, no way that would have been enough room. Absolutely not. Folks, you say I'm obsessed with spacing, but it wouldn't have worked. Now I put a banana there until they grow closer together. behind that is my cotton candy. Another great late season variety that I'm just picking off the last couple of mangoes. And this one, I'm learning you gotta pick it at the right time or it'll get jelly seed inside it. So it still has mangoes on there, but that's ready to come off. That's a cotton candy. And it's a later season mango, a really delicious mango. Cotton candy. That might have been the last two that I pulled off. And as I said, this is a fruit cocktail. There was one hanging in there the other day. I don't know if it's still there. My mangoes and pots are doing pretty good. I upsized them. I got Bombay. I got an apricot. I got a Giselle. I got an emerald. They're looking good. Now, here is a Malika. Malika tree. I had two mangoes on there this year that were excellent. I don't know why people say Malika's hard to ripen, because they ripen beautifully off the tree. That's Malika. In between the Malika and the Pickering, I have a seedling tree that I'm just experimenting to see how it comes out. If it's good, maybe I'll top work it, or I'll take the grafts and top work it. And here is an Edgar. That's an Edgar. No mangoes on Edgar this year. This one here was a seedling that I top work with Timor, I believe. Okay. This is my 1 gallon ST Maui that's grown up now. Looking nice. There's my Kesar. No mangoes on either of those this year. Here's a newer mango I put in the ground this year. That's Sun Puri. Sun Puri. There's a Carla mango, nothing on there this year, but I did get to taste one. It was delicious from someone else. Here's an ice cream. Delicious. I got a bunch on there this year, nothing on there now. Really delicious. And here's a Sessie Love. Nothing on there this year, but very nice. And then coming here, I had an Angie, had several on there this year, but it was more earlier season. This was a star of this year as well, this Pineapple Pleasure. I must have had about 20 or 30 mangoes on there this year, and they were all delicious. Pineapple Pleasure. All right, everybody, that was Mango Land, and that was my yard, and what's happening with the late season mangoes 2024. Remember, I do these videos, yes, for you, to help you understand and know the seasons of mangoes and what's in season and when. And remember, this is for me in Lake Worth, Florida, which is near West Palm Beach. If you're north of me in Jupiter, or even mid-central Florida, or like Orlando, you might be a month later. If you're south of me in Miami or in Fort Lauderdale, you might be a month earlier. But this is my yard, and that was my yard for 2024, we still got those late season mangoes hanging on the tree. In the next video, we'll go over to my neighbor's yard and we'll get an update, a monthly update on what's still ripening at his yard. For more educational videos about mangoes and other fruits and how to grow fruit trees, please look out the other videos on this channel, Fruitful Trees, and also subscribe if you like, and also share these videos with others. Thank you for watching. Have a great day and keep growing.